Hello, welcome to my project. This is Eric. Today I want to share a kind of cute project. I made a Tic Tac camera that can be easily taken out and used at any time using a Tic Tac case. It's battery operated and charges the battery with wireless charging. The way it works is very simple. When the power is connected, the JPEG image with VGA resolution is saved in the SD card. Literally, that's all. ESP32CAM, SD card, battery charger, and Qi wireless charger module are all put in the Tic Tac case. If you ever worked with an ESP32CAM, you can see how simple it is. Let me calculate the cost of making this. I think I paid around 21 bucks. Maybe if you find the cheapest seller, you can make it even cheaper. The video on the upper left of the screen is converted video file from the image files taken with this camera. Converted to video file using FFmpeg. Let's take a closer look. The first one is wireless charging. To charge the battery, it needs to be placed on the Qi wireless charger, not the cable. When charging, the red light is on, and when charging is complete, the green light is on. Since there is not much space in the Tic Tac case, I put a small capacity battery. This is a 3.7V 150 mAh lithium polymer battery. This one is widely used in RC. If you look at the back of the case, you can see the Qi wireless charger module is located at the bottom. The way to turn on the power is through the read of the Tic Tac case. I made the read part as a power switch of the ESP32CAM. When the read is closed, the power circuit is closed, so the battery power is connected to the ESP32CAM 5V. Conversely, when the read is opened, the power circuit is opened and the power is cut off. I made it very simple. So let me tell you a few things you need for this project. First, I want to talk about wireless charging. Many development boards these days include a battery charger module. If there is a pin called VBAD in the pin, most of the battery charger modules are used. In most cases, but not all, you can easily create a wireless charging system by connecting a Qi wireless charger module to the 5V input. One thing to note is that the incoming current voltage from wireless charging is very unstable. That's why we need a constant current voltage module to stabilize it. My favorite TTJ-T display also includes the TP4054, which is a completely constant current voltage linear charger. So I can charge the battery by connecting the Qi wireless charger to the input voltage. In the case of the ESP32CAM, as you know, the battery charger module is not included. So the module I used was Adafruit's battery charger module. You can use this for reliable wireless charging. I was able to get it for around 7 bucks. The charge current is 100 mAh by default. If you want to use the 500 mAh charging current, you can change the charging current by connecting the jumper below. This product was originally made to charge the battery with wired charging with a mini B-type USB jack, but it can also be used for wireless charging without any problem. Only 3.7V and 4.2V batteries are supported. Qi wireless charger received module is the most common module for wireless charger. Outputs up to 5V 1A. I was able to get it for around 3 bucks. This circuit configuration is very intuitive. The red LED turns on when charging starts, and the green LED turns on when charging is complete. At first, I tried to use this battery in Tic Tac case, but there was no room for other parts, so I ended up using a smaller battery. A link to the source code for this project can be found in the description below. The code of this project is a slightly modified version of the source code of the very famous random node tutorials, so please refer to this website for the details of the source code. I will omit the code explanation in this video. When the power is connected, you can see the LED blinking. It blinks whenever an image file is written to the SD card. SD card connected to ESP32CAM is connected to GPIO number 4. When reading and writing a file to SD card, the LED turns on because it goes high. And there is nothing we can do in our code because the hardware architecture is like that. ESP32CAM doesn't have a display, so we don't know if this works right now. If it's not too bright, I think it can be a good way to inform users of its current status. So instead of removing the LED, I'm gonna put some tape over it so it's very slightly visible. This lets me know that the current flow is being taken and saved. I think this is enough. From now on, let's quickly create a Tic Tac case. Find a hole where the OB2640 lens will come out of the Tic Tac case. Draw it with a pen and remove this part. Also remove the lens part from the read part. A mistake I made here was to position the ESP32CAM too high. I think there was room on the read side. It's not in this video, but I made more space below it later. Please keep in mind. The read part works as a switch. The two parts are glued so that they can be connected when closed. Before putting them in the Tic Tac case, I connected all the parts to make sure they are working properly. One thing to keep in mind is that if you put parts in narrow and small case, the parts may come into contact with each other, causing problems. All possible parts should be insulated, so all possible parts were taped using insulating tape. Now let's close the read. You are seeing the LED lights up slightly. This means that it shuts normally and saves the image file to the SD card. Very nice. Now that all the parts are ready, it's time to put the parts inside the Tic Tac case. The tweezers were also taped with insulating tape. I'll put the parts one by one. It's a little clumsy because it's the first time, but I think I'll be better next time. Let's move on. It's done. I pressed it on top of the wireless charger and confirmed that it was charging. The Tic Tac camera is fully charged. Now let's go outside and take a picture. I'm here. I closed the lid of the Tic Tac case. You can see the LED blinking faintly. The weather is so sunny that the LED is barely visible. The video on the upper left is made from the image obtained from this Tic Tac camera. The resolution is 640 by 480 VGA. Let's go for work. After filming is over, I can check many image files on SD card. I use FFmpeg to make this into an MP4 file. Since it is a very popular program, you can find many references. After installing FFmpeg, you can get the same output video file as me through the comment below. If you have any problems, please comment on this video. If there is a chance, I'd like to talk more about wireless charging. This project ends here. I hope you enjoyed this project. Okay then, see you in the next project.